So you come up closer. Oh, sorry, I didn't think about that. Over here. I go the other way. So I wanted to start with showing you an IMO shoebox that I put here Friday morning or Thursday night, and it might be ready. And if it is, this is like the most exciting moment, to pull out this IMO shoebox that's full of the white mycelium. So, and also this is just a good lesson in how to do it. In Hawaii, this part of Hawaii, we have to deal with rain a lot, so I generally cover it from the rain. You don't want it getting wet. And then you pile the leaves around as much as possible. Mango leaves work really well. This spot usually works well too. The avocado leaves. And then this is to keep the mice out of there, which will come eat the rice. And then here's the box. Oh,
yay!
Nothing.
So, puppy yet?
No.
How many days? Little tiny bit.
Yeah, how many days?
This was Thursday night.
Already?
Should have been.
You know, I think there's not enough right moisture around it. It's getting too dry.
It's been really dry. And generally, I like the dry.
Let's ask Mr. Cho. Oh. 이게 4일 됐는데 아무 별로 안 했어요.
저기 이게 왜 그렇게 됐냐 그러면은 그
강화가
여기가 공기가 들어가야 되는데 공기가 못 들어갔어.
Oh, the reason that it didn't work, there should be able air can go through, but the, on the side there's hardly any
enough air.
Yeah, not enough air.
This box usually works as a little tiny bit in the corner.
Yeah, they only develop in the corner.
So, but it should be just filled with the white mycelium.
So, when you cut it, you put it here, you put it on the side, you put it on the side, you put it on the side. 3cm.
So when you make a container, at the bottom too, there's a few small pieces.
Yeah, this is a few pieces. This usually works, but it has been, the weather's been really different.
Dry.
Yeah, so, very dry.
So what you do in case when weather is too dry, you just spray around some water, not here, around there. So you create about 65%. Moisture. That's what I did on mine. That's why it developed well.
55% moisture. Yeah.
오케이. There's another one that mistake is she used the big leaf with lots of space in between. When you're collecting IMO one, you need the leaf that broke down and make it small pieces. They have to touch each other. That way microorganisms can propagate better. Mm-hmm. When there's a space, it takes a longer time to, propagate.
So they should touch each other.
Yeah, should touch each other. Yeah. That's why the best one is bamboo leaf. They always touch each other. When you even collect, they stay together. I don't know, you saw the bamboo leaf that I collect from the forest and I brought in a workshop. Yeah, these leaves are too big and has too much space. That's the reason, one of the reasons, another reason. So when it's a dry like this,
first thing you need to do, you place it and then spray some water around. When it's dry like this, right now maybe moisture content is maybe 47%. That's it. But the micro needs 65 to 70% moisture. Yeah.
And also, he mentioned, not only just leave, but also if you go to the under the tree, the fallen leaves are decaying. Then if you see under the leaves, there's some soft soil developing. That's what we call leaf mold. So you have...
Right, good.
So what Master Cho is saying is not only the fallen leaves, but also the soil under the leaves, that you can see some, you know, decaying kind of leaves mixed, becoming to soil. That's what we call the leaf mold. That's the best one, you put it on over.
This one usually takes four days.
And this has been about 4 days?
Yeah. It should have been developed already.
One good thing, if it comes out like this, it comes out too soggy and you have to throw it out, you're only wasting a few days and 2 cups of rice. So you can start over.
So what he's saying again, do not use a big leaf like this. The one already broke down. The smaller leaf that's kind of stick together. Also, some of the soil around there, you put it on. Use that. That's it.
You
can see that.
Leaf mold.
You need to collect. This white mold is on. You need to collect those kind of leaf. Not the big leaf. Yeah.
그리고 여러분 여기 이제 이 나무를 봐가지고 지금 이제 이게 저기 사람으로만 피부암 걸린 거라고.
So when if you look at this tree, you have to observe that those mold is like a compared to the human, that's a skin disease on their skin right now.
그리고 여기 이거.
The lichen.
이거. 이것은 화상을 입은 거야. 빛에 띄어서 화상을 입은 거야.
So especially those mark, they are burned by the sun. It's like a sunburn right now.
그래서 이게 이제 화상으로 진물이 나오니까 이런 것들이 나서 아주 싫은 거예요.
So when they have a sunburn and there's a sticky stuff comes out, ooze out, and then those mold is starting to grow.
Fungus,
yeah.
그래서 여기 이런 게 생기기 시작하면 저 꼭대기까지 올라가거든. 그럼 나무가 죽어.
When the sunburn is it go up to on top, all over like that, too many sunburn, the tree is starting to die.
그래서 이걸 갖다 바로 잡으려면은 토창수를 4번을 과시키고 바닷물을 1대 20. 그걸 우리가 액화시키는 거야. 그리고 거기다 이제 그 인산 칼슘. 그렇게 하고, 근데 그렇게 해서 이걸 뿌리면 흘러내리지 않아?
이게 잠깐만. So, when you have that condition, you need to make a liquid iron 4 and then water soluble calcium phosphate. You mix it in the water and you ocean water is 1 to 20. Yeah.
20:1이죠.
Yeah. And then water soluble calcium.
1:20.
Yeah. Water soluble calcium phosphate is 1 to 1,000. You mix it and you start spraying all over.
How about the liquid IMO 4?
Yeah, that's liquid IMO 1 to 500.
Liquid IMO 4는 아니. 미생물 액체 미생물 4번은 몇 대?
그 몇 대 일이 아니라 물 10리터에 1kg 넣는 거예요.
So in 10 liter of the water,
you put 1 kilo of the IMO 4 in the sack, you soak it. Use that water.
물은 바닷물 1대 20을 넣은 바닷물이라고.
So that water is already you put 1 to 20 ratio of ocean water. So ocean water is go into 10 liter of the water already.
근데 그걸 갖다 여기다 뿌리면 흘러내리거든.
So when you spray that, they are flowing down to the tree.
그래서 거기다 찹쌀 있잖아. 찹쌀 죽을 수 아주 그걸 넣어서 하면은 끈기가 점착제 역할을 하기 때문에 달라붙어.
찹쌀을 어디다 넣어?
죽을 수 가지고 찹쌀 죽을 수 가지고 엉덩이랑 섞어.
So also another thing you need to do is cook sweet rice and make a chuk. Yeah? And then you mix that porridge and you mix that in the water and then you spray it. While they are falling or streaming down, it will stick to the tree. Yeah, they will help to stick the tree.
Yeah. 그래서 이게 고쳐져.
Then it will starting to heal.
이거 그냥 놔두면 이게 피부가 부풀려서 떨어지거든. 그럼 거기에 상처가 나기 때문에 이런 게 생겨.
So if you don't do any treatment, they will swell up and fall down, and they're starting to grow that kind of a fungus.
Once or you repeat couple of times or you know
till it grows. 그 몇 번씩 날 때까지 해야 되지.
So try until it heals.
Yeah. Wow. 근데 대개 그거는 일주일 간격으로 한 번씩 뿌리는.
So you do that between once a week.
여기 요거는 사람으로 말하면 아도피 걸린 거예요.
If you this green moss is compared to human, it's atopy. Skin atopy disease.
나무에 생기면은 산소를 빨아먹기 때문에 이 나무 자체 산소가 모자라.
But then when it happens to the tree, this green moss will take the oxygen from the tree, so they have a lack of oxygen. Yeah. So you need to clean it.
청소를 해줘야죠.
아니 아니. 이거 하려면 어떻게 해야 되냐 그러면은. 그 바닷물 1대 20에다가 주산미생 4번 액화시킨 거에다가 거기다가 한방영양제 현미시초 그걸 넣어주게 되면 이게 없어져 버려.
So what you need to do, there's a four thing has to use. OHN, brown rice vinegar, liquid IMO4. ocean water.
그렇게 해서 그걸 뿌려주게 되면 여기
이런 게 없어져. Then that green moss gonna disappear.
지금 이게 산소가 나무에 산소가 모자라기 때문에 바람이 지는 거야.
Because right now this tree has a lack of the oxygen, so it's keep falling. They're turning into leaves, turning into brown, and keep falling right now.
그래서 이런 나무에 여기 요거 생겼으면 전부 다 일사병 그 햇볕에 의해서 화상을 입은 걸로 보면 돼요.
So right now this tree has a lot of sunburn.
이제 이렇게 해서 그 혈액순환이 제대로 안 되니까 이런 게 생기는 거예요.
So when you have a lot of sunburn, they don't have a good blood flow, not enough good circulation. That's why all those green moss starting to grow.
Aloha!
Aloha! Until it disappears. But the treatment has to be once a week.
지금 여기 이렇게 되면 나무가 썩어 죽어.
Now, when there are so many green moss, trees starting to rot. So spray those nutrients and then heal this tree.
Lois. You know how to make?
Yeah, okay. Yeah. 그럼 토분을 좀 거기 넣어서 뿌리면 훨씬 더 효과가 커.
So add the low.
Yeah. 얼마큼 넣냐 그러면은
3% of the loess. Loess is the powder of the red dirt, you know? And there's a specific way to make that, but she knows how to do it. So if you add it to the solution that you explained, you know, the IMO4, liquid IMO4, the ocean water 120, and calcium phosphate, all these things. In addition to that, if you put the lowest, three percent.
What is
it? Don't have a time enough to explain. Yeah.
Yeah, in the book. It's in the book.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's
much
more
over to this
town. Okay. Yeah. Do you have some?
Lois?
Lois?
No, but we have the mill run.
Ah, yeah.
We make IMO3.
Yeah. IMO, 지금 저쪽 가서 IMO3분 되는 것보다.
So let's head over to the little shed and we'll put together an IMO3 pilot.
Got it.
It's too expensive compared to the simple one, yeah.
But it could work.
If you use it, it'll work. But it's too expensive for, yeah.
Right.
So, Dr. Park, this is some mill run that we've had for many years now. Uh-huh. Never used. But it's degraded. Is it okay to use?
이게 오래된 밀원, 저 밀기울 했는데 여기 굉장히 오래됐는데 이거 그래도 사용해야 되냐고.
이건 지금 미생물이 휴면상태 들어왔어요. 잠을 자고 있다고.
This is a dormant stage right now of the microorganism.
It's just mill run.
It's just 이거는 만든 건 아니고 그냥 밀기울만 갖다가 놨대요. 여기다가 굉장히 오래 두었었대요.
근데 여기다가 어떠냐면 그 기왕에 있는 여기에다가 밀기울을 조금 더 넣어.
예. 더 넣고 새거 새 밀기울.
예.
Okay. If you can just, you can use that one, although she stored this, the mill run the long time over there. This can be used, you added some fresh mill run.
Oh,
then use that one, yeah.
Okay, well I don't have any fresh. I have some bagasse and biochar.
저 사탕수수 말른 거, 빻은 거 있잖아요, 버게스. 그거 바이오차도 있고 저희 숯도 있고 근데 그거하고 섞으면 괜찮고
섞은 데다가 숯돌 마실 때 바닷물을 꼭 넣어서 마시고
Okay, one thing we have to make sure when you make this moisture content which is usually 60-70% use the ocean water. Okay?
Okay, well I don't have any ocean water.
Hey, ocean water is right there.
No, I don't have any water.
Right now. No, later on.
1-30 or?
Always when you use the ocean water, don't use the full strength. You gotta dilute 1-30, and you mix with that.
그래서 그렇게 하면은 이제 체질이 강해지니까.
That makes the strong IMO.
So should we not use it till we get the ocean water?
지금 좀 보여주려고 그러는데 그냥 해도 되냐 안 그러면
바닷물이 있으면 바닷물을 섞어서
지금 못 되는데 당장은
없으면 그냥 그 한방여행제 하고
So you have OHN?
No.
없대.
설탕수수 무거워.
So how about the sugar juice? Sugar cane juice? Yeah, 있대.
그럼 그걸 갖다 sugar juice를
1-500 sugar cane juice.
그래도 그걸 다 수분을 맞춰서
And then you make this moisture content 60-70%. Yeah.
So I have a question. Okay? Because I get on IMO4, I noticed I have lots of those.
그것도 괜찮냐고 그러면. That's okay.
If we mill run when you store them up and the bugs come in and make that up.
Yeah, 그걸 집 저 두면은 벌레들이 와서 저렇게 만드는데요.
벌레들이 와서 만드는 게 아니라 벌레가 생긴 거예요.
Yeah. So that created the.
왜냐면 벌레지가 오면 똥 싸잖아. 똥 싸면 똥에 기생을 달려붙잖아. 네. 달려붙어서 끈끈해지거든. 네. 이렇게
만들어. 네. This is formed by the by you know when you have a mealworm, the insects or bugs will come after that. They make a doo-doo. Then they make a stickier. So that's the reason why the form is like this. All the microorganisms will come after the doo-doo. So that's it's a whole bunch of the microorganisms.
That's great.
So actually this is better than powder.
I see some bugs.
Lots of microorganisms here. Because they came after the doo-doo of the insects.
Microorganisms eat that waste.
So rather than completely digested food, if it is half digested, not raw, but half digested one, if you have a lot of microorganism with that, if you spray it to the ground, dirt, then they will continue working on there. So rather than completely digest one, half digest one may work better, working more actively.
그리고 이걸 쌀 때 기온이 높다, 외부의 기온이 높다, 그럼 이걸 갖다 20cm 정도 쌓고 두께를 기온이 낮다, 그럼 50cm 정도 쌓는 거야. 그래야 발효가 제대로 돼.
If the outside the temperature is too high, then the height of this mound should be lower, and if it's cold, then it's higher. The low means is 20 centimeter, which is 8 inches, and if it is cold, then you go high, which is 50 centimeter.
그래서 이게 여기가 이 온도가 60 내지 70도가 올라가야 돼, 섭씨.
The temperature, ideally speaking, with the hopefully for the 60-70% centigrade. Centigrade means it's about 120 something like degree Fahrenheit. Yeah.
여기 이제 보너스가 있는데 그건 뭐냐면 열이 60 내지 70도 올라갈 때 여기 들어가서 이걸 쓰고서 목욕을 해 사우나가.
Yeah. There is a bonus for you, and when you have a heat. The centigrade 60-70%, you go bury yourself and the cover up, and then there's a sauna. That'll be very, very good. If you do that, your cancer will be cured.
Part-time in Alaska, and the ground is so cold that it's difficult sometimes. Like, is there any way you could
kind of
like apply some heat to help it along?
저 알래스카는 너무 추워서 이거 흔들려고 할 때 어떻게 좀 딱 저 쉽게 한다.
알래스카가 몇 도까지 내려가?
How low it go down in Alaska?
What do you mean how
low?
Well, in the day, because I'm near the ocean, it'll get like 65, and then at night, like 40.
Oh, 65 degrees Fahrenheit 되면은 한 2, 3, 2, 5도, 35도 이래요.
그럴 때는 어떻게 하냐 그러면은 이걸 갖다가 파고. 파고서.
I think it's just my fingers.
Here's IMO2.
It's quite old
one.
So you boil the water and put it in there. And you bury that. Okay. So one way to do is you boil the water, put into the bottle, bury inside the, you know, this mill run, then the, all the microorganism feels very warm, not cold. Okay?
Thank you.
Yeah. Genius. Same thing, if you're too cold in your blanket, then make this hot water bottle in next to your the body, then you feel warm. Why you have a head on top of your body to use it? I am a two.
Good.
This is IMO number two.
A long time ago. 2 years?
그래서 여러분들이 이걸 갖다 미생물을 번식시키는 나온 열, 그걸 발효열이라고 그러거든. 그 발효열을 활용해서 내 몸의 비움을 고치는 거 아주 중요한 거예요.
So one very good bonus today is that when you want to make a very healthy body, try to use this fermentation fever. Fermented fever out of this one, IMO number 3 or 4 process. When you make the 3 to 4, mm-hmm. you get the heat developed from the fermentation.
Yes.
You go inside.
Oh.
Yeah.
Lay on it.
You bury it in it.
Yeah,
and then that will make your health body. Even cancer will be cured.
암세포는 섭씨 45년에서 다 죽어.
The reason why we say, the reason why this IMO heat or the fermentation heat will cure the cancer patient is because cancer cell can die if your temperature becomes 40 to 45 degrees centigrade. So it can develop that high.
그런데 만약에 물이 60도, 70도 됐다면 사람이 들어가면 기어 죽는다고 못 들어가.
If you go into the water temperature 60 to 70 degrees centigrade, you're going to burn to die.
만약에 햇볕이 60도 내지 70도 됐다면 다 죽어.
If the sunlight temperature is 60, 70 degrees centigrade, the people will get sunburn and they die.
그런데 미생물이 만들어낸 온도는 60도, 70도가 돼도 사람이 들어가도 아무 상관이 없어.
The difference between the temperature or fever developed the fermentation by the microorganism is safe. You don't die with it. All the temperature itself is the same. If it's a burning water, I mean the boiling water, 60, 70 degree, or sunlight, 60, 70 degrees centigrade, you cannot tolerate. You will die. Your cells will be dead. But not the fermentation fever created by the microorganism.
그래, 거기에 들어가 있으면은 그 더운 열이 몸에 들어가기 때문에 암세포가 다 죽는 거야.
So, if you bury it into that IMO4, hot IMO4 the temperature, then they will come to your body to kill this cancer cell.
그래서 제일 잘 낫는 게 폐암이 제일 잘 낫는데.
The best cancer they have treated in Japan is lung cancer.
그래서 여러분들이 말이죠, 자연농으로만 자연농으로 하는 거에 의해서 생기는 부산물이
The side benefit of you doing this natural farming, you have a lot of side benefit, and the mindset will be a very multiply and then abundant, But the other health effect will be this another very good side effect.
그리고 여러분들 그 위장의 위액이지 위액 위액 위액.
The you know the stomach juice, gastric secretion.
그 1cc에
One cc of that, one ml, milliliter.
1cc에 얼만큼 미생물 들어있냐면 1조 마리가 들어있어.
Oh, 1조 means about 100 million or 100 billion microorganisms inside 1 cc of the stomach juice. There's lots of microorganisms.
그래서 여러분들이 만약에 위장이 안 좋다 했을 땐 토착미생물 4번을 액화시켜서 그 물을 마시게 되면 아주 회복이 빨라.
So, in that rationale, if you have a stomach trouble, then you make a liquid IMO4 and then you drink it, then that will replace the whatever is not enough the stomach the microorganism. Same principle LAB that I taught you yesterday.
근데 내가 의사가 아닌데 그런 얘기를 하면 법에 걸려서 쫓겨나지.
I'm not a licensed physician, so if I say that the way you treat this your cancer and everything, I'll be kicked away.
근데 우리 박 원장님은 의사님이요. 의사님이 이렇게 통역을 했으니까 관계 없고.
The licensed physician, Dr. Park, translated him. So that's no problem.
의심하지 말고 활용해 보세요.
So without any question or doubt, you try.
그래서 이 자연을 놓고 봤을 때 사람의 위장하고 토양은 똑같은 거예요.
So when you compare with this nature, the dirt or soil is similar to the stomach of the human being.
그래서 이 위장의 미생물이 풍부하고 다양하게 건강한 이면 병이 안 걸려.
So when you have enough variety of the microorganism in your body or stomach, then you don't have to worry about getting sick.
그래서 일단 이제 바설 도둑이 보고지만도 이 밭에는 토착 미생물이 아주 풍부해. 그래서 작물이 병도 안 걸리고 잘 자라.
So we're going to look around these crops around here. So you can see this their abundance of the microorganisms in this particular Ginger Jam's farm or Jackie's farm. So they don't get sick very much.
자, 그럼 이거 뭐 만든다 그래 만들어.
You want to show?
You want to make a pile now?
Yeah.
Okay.
지금 만들어
볼까요? Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So go ahead.
Okay. I think there's some bags of bagasse against the wall there. You could use probably one or two of them. And then the biochar can go on top.
Is this the bagasse?
Yeah. 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 Okay.
Yeah.
This bagasse, some of you may not know what the bagasse. It's after squeeze this sugar cane juice, the leftover, you dry up and then make this small pieces like that. It's a bagasse powder or bagasse. It's very sweet. So we are making number three, yeah? I am on number three out of number two now.
So this is just the IMO 2 in here.
Yeah.
And
so,
we have some sugarcane juice here.
Okay. Just like Master Cho suggested, she's adding the bagasse, which is very sweet.
Still, it's a little bad.
Mm. Okay. Jackie, you like this other bucket?
Yeah, we're gonna need all the
bucket.
So, oh yeah, let's get a little more bagasse.
Can you get some more bagasse?
I don't think there's any more there. Oh, no more. Okay, okay. And then just keep the dust down.
This is a biochar You know the purpose of biochar? Biochar is a very good living apartment for the IMO. Housing. Plus, the biochar has a, there's a moisture holding capacity. So, it's a very, very good.
So, the next step, we just mix it by hand.
Yeah.
You're going to go up to Chris Trump's. I think he's got a mechanism or implement on his tractor that mixes it now.
Yeah. So, we can do the by hand. If you want to try, just come and mix with it. Mix it with your hand.
Yeah, and break up those chunks.
So, if you mix with a hand rather than machine, then you have extra microorganism existing in your bodies, your skins around your hands and arms. Why, Master Cho is using English. When you do this, don't think you're doing hard work, labor, but you just feel like you touch the best lover's skinship.
Massage therapy.
Massage therapy of not anybody, but the best lover. Just a minute. So, when you try to make a ball shape with the hands, if there is no breaking down, that moisture content is about 60-70%. Yeah. 여기 저 천의 녹즙. 천의 녹즙. 여기 저 냄새 맡은 거 있어. So, if you make the, you know, you squeeze this one, make a ball shape, it does not break. That's too much moisture.
So you added FPJ to the water too, and IMO too, and some sugar cane juice.
So far, as Jackie said, IMO 2 with sugar cane juice, and we have some charcoal with the mill run.
We can way down make another bottom. Big hole. Break apart those big holes.
You have the shovel. You have a shovel?
Yeah, I
feel
right here.
Okay. Yeah. Shovel.
Now, Master Joe, we'll give it to Mr. Riley here.
Making love, John. Making love.
We're gonna need a lot more water.
I don't know.
Wait. In you.
Turn around.
Back and forth.
Yeah, okay, I got it.
It's
over here.
Yeah,
we can do it.
Yeah,
여기다 물 좀 더 볼게요. I'm a senior old man strength.
shovel it back here, right? Okay, watch it.
Yeah, back to the same. So make a different mound and then go back. That way it all homogeneously mix.
So this was the last of the mill runs from the mill on Oahu closed, and now it's still available in Kilo Adam.
They're asking, they want you to talk in the mic.
Yeah, here.
She got one.
Look at this. This is enough. Look at this. Right now, about 60-70% moisture now.
Now,
yeah. So make the height 8 inches high.
8 inches high.
So you have to cover after this because the sunlight will kill the microorganism. About 8 inches high.
Jackie, you got the sheet?
This is too much moisture. If you have a footprint, I mean fingerprint on your palm, then that's too much moisture.
What do you mean?
Can you say that again, please?
Okay.
If you 여기 저 손자국이 남는
손자국이 남은 수분이 많은 거라고.
So if you have the palm print, after you hold it tight and the let it go, then that's too much moisture. Everything has to be cleared.
저 그리고 이걸 만들 때 직사광선 쏘면은 이게 죽으니까 여기다 그 멀티 그 이거
그늘을
지켜줘야
돼. Because of the sunlight will kill this microorganism, you have to make a shade or mulching.
So the mill run, you get at Hawai'i, and they're behind the target there.
Do not use chemical sheet, no plastic kind, okay? The best cover of this one is the rice straw. Any questions? No, not now.
We use leaves like banana leaves, coconut fronds. We pile them over. Yeah.
Instead of sheet. Banana,
banana.
Yeah, you can use the you know, the palm leaves, banana leaves like that, instead of this sheet, that's still okay. The purpose is you have make a little shade so that it won't hit this direct sunlight.
Compost thermometer without using thermometer, how do you know it's 110,
120, 130? Okay. 얼마 자기가 열이 얼마나 남아있는 걸 온도계를 재야 되느냐? 안 그러면 어떻게 배가 알 수 있느냐?
내 몸의 온도가 몇 도야? 36도지.
So, what's your temperature of your body?
100.
About 36, 37 degrees?
Centigrade.
Or 98, 99 degrees? Yeah? Okay.
So, you can't do it. You can't do it. You can't do it. You can't do it. You can't do it.
So, if you stick your finger or hand into there and you feel hot, then that's too hot. More than 60 degrees, 70 degrees centigrade.
그럴 때 어떻게 여기 뒤집어?
In that case, what you have to do is just turn upside down.
네, 그렇게 해서 만들면 되고.
If they wanted the accurate the moisture content, this is the way. Yeah?
We stick it in
temperature. How about temperature? I'm sorry.
That's a compost. 그리고
이걸 높이 쌓으면은 막 50cm, 60cm 쌓게 되면 수분이 밑창 내려가기 때문에 밑창엔 수분이 많아지고 위는 수분이 적어지기 때문에 평등이 아니요.
Yeah. So if you pile up not 20 centimeter or 8 inches high, but 15 centimeter, which is the more than double, then moisture content go down. Then there is an unbalance between top and bottom.
그렇기 때문에 그 기후가 외부의 기온이 한 20도 정도 올라갔다 그러면 20cm, 내려갔다 그러면 한 50cm 그렇게 쌓으면.
So if you outside is hot, 20 centimeter is right. If it's cold, 50 centimeter.
So pancake or muffin?
Huh?
Pancake or muffin?
Oh, pancake. 팬케이크 만드는 것 같다고. Yeah.
똑같아.
Right now, there's no rice straw available. If you grow dry land rice, it'll grow in Hawaii.
그리고 저희 그 만약에 멀칭할 게 마땅치 않다 그러면 옥수수나 슈가케인 그 말린 걸 엮어 가지고 덮으면 괜찮아요.
If you don't have this ideal the rice straw, then either corn stalk or banana or whatever, then you just make a little the string, and then you can use that one too.
그러니까 주변에 있는 걸 활용해가지고.
So whatever is available in your area, use it rather than just buy it everywhere.
그렇게 해서 만들어가지고 온도가 60도에서 70도 올라갔다 그러면 밭에다 뿌리기 전에 자기가 먼저 뭐뭐 갖다 사우나를 한번 보면은 아도피나 이런 것들 깨끗하게 나죠.
So if you do have if you do find out the temperature went up to 60, 70 degrees centigrade or more than 100 degrees Fahrenheit, then before you using the soil, you yourself get the benefit of that sauna.
이게 거기 얼마큼 되냐면 15분 정도.
You bury yourself about 15 minutes. I had one experience in Korea. Because he arranged that. And that was really, really hot, but I didn't get burned.
Perfect size here.
Yeah. Yes, question.
Instead of the mill run, could you use coffee parchment? Talking about like using okay. What you have around.
Mill run 대신에 저희 밀주 대신에 그 커피 껍데기 있잖아요. 그걸 저 사용해도 되냐고.
안 돼.
No.
Is it 왜 그러냐면 커피 껍데기는 저기 자극성인 게 들어있어.
There's a strong stimulant there.
But is it the carbohydrate?
Yeah, the carbohydrate. That's the main thing.
Carbohydrate.
Yeah.
What about oat hulls?
Huh?
Oat.
Oat.
Oat hulls.
Oat cars.
Oat.
Oat.
That's okay. So primarily, the purpose is a carbohydrate.
And it's also the size particles. They need to be touching each other.
Mm. Yeah.
Like the leaves over the box.
Mm. Right. The size of the particle should be the very small. You know the tapioca or cassava?
Yeah.
You can use that one. You just dry it, and make a powder, and use that one. Same thing. Yeah.
Has IMO ever been used for the heat, to heat a greenhouse in colder climates?
그 IMO 만들어가지고 그 저희 하우스, 그린하우스에 저 써도 되냐, 그 히터. Very good. You can use it. Yeah.
Can you use some sawdust?
Wood chip? 톱밥. 그안 그러면 저 나무 자른 거, 그런 거 쓸 수 있어요. No. No.
그냥 그러면 톱밥을 만약에 쓰려고 그러면 톱밥에다가
If you want to use that sawdust, you have to mix with seawater and ferment it first, and then use it. Well, the reason is the sawdust is acid. Ocean water is alkaline. So you can neutralize by putting together with the seawater and then, you know,
like straight seawater.
Sawdust. No, always 1:30. 그 그냥 뭐야 아니야 1:30.
아니 원액으로.
원액으로.
예.
Oh, I'm sorry. You have to be the original water or the seawater, not the diluted 1:30.
Oh.
Yeah, he said.
Okay, so you use pure seawater.
Wow. Yeah, pure
seawater.
Only when you use the sawdust.
And how long do you ferment it for before you use it?
얼만큼이나 오랫동안 발효? 1 week.
Doctor, do you know what the obesia tree is? The obesia that it's caused a lot of problem
in
the
obesia.
Yeah. That I've heard from people the obesia is nitrogen fixer tree. And then they can use as a, you know, for the replacement of middle run. But is that possible?
Albizia라고 여기 많이 나는 그 잡나무들이 많거든요. 거기도 그 저 이런 걸로 좀 그 가루 만들어가지고 이런 걸 쓸 수 있는.
네, 그래도 그 나무기 때문에 산성이 많기 때문에 바닷물에다 칠해가지고.
Same thing. It has a lot of acid. So you gotta treat with this sea water first, fermenting.
Something about using some potato or other starch when you use sawdust. Is that cooked or dried?
저 감자나 이런 걸 대치를 한다 그러면 그걸 쿡 저 삶아서
말려가지고
삶아서 말려. Okay, so cook it, the boil it, and then dry it,
okay.
And make a powder.
Okay, gotcha.
Is it important to pH the water when you're making your IMO?
저희 pH 그 산성할 때에서 그걸 정확하게 맞춰야 되느냐 아니면
이제 그거는 해봐가지고 기저 산도 측정기가 있으면은 네. 4, 5번은 강산성이에요.
네.
6, 7이면 중성이고
네.
7, 8이면은 알칼리야.
네.
그러니까 6, 7에다 맞춰야 되는데 그걸 몇 번 해보면은 어느 모양에서 가장 잘 자란다 그걸 보고서 본인들이
So you don't have to measure every time unless you're the brand new farmers that you don't even know what it looks like. But once you know what is good, what is not good, then ideally speaking, he wants to make this pH between 6 and 7. But if it's like a 4 or 5, it's too acid. If you go beyond the 6, 7, 8 like that, that's a too strong alkaline. So ideally, wanted to have a six between 6 and 7, but you don't have to measure it every time. If you get used to making it, then you can kind of feel this is about the right. That's the way.
Thank
you. The best thing is you try taste yourself.
그러면 산도가 높다 그러면 자기도 알 것 아니에요. 이제 알칼리가 높다면 알칼리가 높은 것도 알고 있고. 그러니까 가장 좋은 것은 어떤 거냐? 내 입맛에 맞는 단맛.
So if you're too acid, then you can feel that's acidity. Versus the too much alkaline, you feel the kind of burning into. So if you wanted to keep tasting, then you will find the best sweet taste that you can feel. That's the one that you want to reach.
Dr. Park, when you ferment the sawdust, the same moisture, 60-65%.
Yeah. 그 거기 지금 저 톱밥을 저거 쓰려고 할 때도 60-70% moisture. Yeah, same. So dust also. Yeah.
If it's get put the hands in, if it's get too hot, lactic acid bacteria, you can use it to cool down or
then turn it.
Yeah, but turning sometimes if it's overheating, what
No, it'll cool it down.
I had a two experience. It's just like
Giving up or the solution. 지금 세미나를 하고 있습니다.
Giving up or the solution.
네, 지금 세미나를 하고 있어서 예, 지금 세미나.
Yeah, yeah, of course. 네, try 네. turning, and still just heating.
거기다가
너무
too much. Too much.
돌리라고 그랬더니 거기다 유산균을 좀 집어넣으면 어떠냐?
안 돼.
No.
No.
No lactic acid bacterium when it's too hot. Just turn it on. If you feel that all the food is very tasty, if you eat too much or overeat, then you got a stomach trouble, right?
마찬가지로 이것도 지나치면 모자라는 것만 못하다고 말해요.
Same thing. Too much is worse than too little. Maybe you can move on to the next. Otherwise, it's going to be all day.
그럼 파설 한번 가보죠.
Let's go to see this. Some of the crops here. Hold on. Jinja John will explain first before we go around.
Yeah. Good morning.
Good morning.
Aloha.
Aloha.
So I just want to give you a little history of the aina here and how it's transformed. When I came up here 11 years ago, this is all bare, naked poison. There wasn't one blade of grass here. There were no worms. This whole place, there are no coconut trees, there are no banana trees, there's nothing here except poison, like down below. And that was 9 years ago. I got in touch with Dr. Park and Kura Natural Farming. And Jackie and I started making our first IMO piles down Kalapana. And we just started farming here. And we had six flats of parsley that I had just planted in six flats of poha berries. And as an experiment, half the trays I put some IMO 4 in them, and the other half I didn't. And in 2 weeks, the trays that had the IMO 4, the plants were twice as large, and the cups were full of roots. So I built this barn just for making IMO 4. And I had a kalo, I had a taro field over here. I've been trying to grow taro for a year and a half, and because of all the conventional farmers around here, I couldn't get anything to grow on this property because there are no microorganisms in the soil. Or there were no worms in the soil. So after making IMO 4s for a couple of months, it was 9 years ago in November, we had a big storm for 3 days, and then it stopped storming, and I went out and I dumped 1,000 pounds of IMO 4 under my kalo fields. And then it stormed again, and I came back on Thanksgiving Day and I started pulling back the mulch, and it was all worms. So I knew at that point that this is biological farming, what we're doing here. We're farming we're taking care of the soil. We take care of the soil, and everything else is taken care of. And so I've learned a lot since that time. I used to buy like $15,000-$20,000 worth of this organic fertilizer from the mainland. And when I started dumping out these IMOs, I realized that this is real sovereignty. This is working with what we have, and it's from here. The important thing that I learned, though, the most important thing is the first time Master Cho came here, I had an IMO4 pile here. And it was covered with a plastic shade cloth. And his daughter was saying, "No, no, no, this is no good. You can't do this." And Master Cho said something, and everybody started laughing. And what he said was, "It's not so important that what I did, it's your enthusiasm that really counts." You know, and we can go to these classes and go to these classes and take notes, but it's only going to work when you apply your enthusiasm and your gratitude. Your gratitude for being here and having this opportunity to live on this beautiful planet and be a part of this beautiful creation without participating in its destruction.
Yeah. Yeah.
So the last couple of years, I did this for like 4 or 5 years steady, and I've been kind of busy doing other things, so I haven't been making my IMO4 piles. But everything here is, you know, the important thing is when you start this process, I have a lot of organic farmer friends, and many people are afraid to take that initial step to change their paradigm. It takes faith, and it takes trust. And it takes faith and trust that the Creator created this creation perfectly. You know, and we're going to get what we need, you know, to make our life. This type of farming really brings peace to your life. That's what everybody wants. They want to find some peace in their life. And you can do this. And it's not about making money or getting rich, but it's just going out there and growing, being a part of this harvesting of nutrient-dense food. Because what we eat is our health. And this is the best way to stay healthy, is this Cho Natural Farming. It's pretty awesome. So when Master Cho came up here years ago, I told him that at one point, I've been farming my whole life, and I was up here living in this poison land, and I couldn't get anything to grow. And I felt like I was becalmed. In other words, I was in the middle of the ocean in a boat, and there was no wind. And I was going nowhere. I was about to die out in the middle of the ocean. And then Cho Natural Farming came, and it was like the trade winds kicked in, my sails filled up with air, and away we went. And it just kind of took over. So thank you, Master Cho. Yeah, we owe a lot to you.
Thank you.
So all the food here, the bananas, the kalo, the sugarcane, the ulus. I'm really into ulus. I think ulus is the future, man. It's really amazing, amazing tree and food product. I've been into it for a long time. This all goes to the cafe. And you know, for decades I've been growing the kalo, and I never sold it. I gave it away because nobody would give me the money that it's worth. At 50 cents a pound, give me a break, man. It's cost me $5 a pound to grow it. But now we have the opportunity to bring it from the field to the table. And it's so beautiful to go in there and see the local community consuming this food right from, it's like from their backyard. That's so, you know, we'll go look at the sugarcane fields and you know, see what's going on here. But it's, you can see it's all green. You know, and the other thing, it came up last night, it comes up all the time. People are always concerned about the weeds. You know, weeds are fine. Green is good. You know, people have this concept
that they want things to look a certain way. But that's not the way nature is. Nature has her own design, and we need to recognize nature's design and work with it. And don't, you know, be practical and just do what you can do. Don't set yourself up to where you have to use poisons because there's too many weeds. The weeds are a good thing. They're if you bulldoze the earth, she doesn't want to stay bare under the ultraviolet light. She immediately produces what they call weeds. And these weeds, they're designed to heal the soil. They're designed to bring up the nutrients that it needs. So they're really a good thing. So see that big clump of grass there? Underneath that is my compost. You see all these clumps of grass on my farm? So, you know, I pull up all my weeds, we get compost from the cafe, whatever I get, and I bring the compost out and I just put it on the ground. It starts growing grass. It starts growing weeds. So I'll let it grow for like a year. I have a tractor with the loader. I'll push all that grass over and the roots are just all white with indigenous microorganisms. That whole pile has been digested by the roots and I get this pure, beautiful compost. And then I make another compost out of that. So it's like my compost piles, they make puppies. They just keep making more compost piles, you know? So it's kind of a neat thing. Well, should we go take a tour and just look around?
Yeah. You want to keep that? I mean,
huh? Okay.
Yeah, I don't know if you want to
talk. It's used for depression and anxiety.
Yeah,
kratom.
What is
kratom? Kratom.
You grow that?
Yeah, kratom. Awesome. Well, let's go up here and look at the sugarcane field.
How much land do you have?
18 acres.
Is that you?
Ah, if we get too close to each other, it happens.
Start squealing.
Yeah.
Learned
to stay up with the farm.
So what do you have?
In
Curtistown.
Yeah.
And you've been doing work with Mason for 8 years?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
I was supposed to come up and just to Maya over
staying
with you.
Uh-huh.
You know,
you're going to
be here for
you,
April.
Yeah, I mean,
we'll
be flexible with that.
Yeah.
Like my farm, we could do it quick.
Yeah.
Like.
So, you know, this is, is this working?
No. Hello? Yeah, it's working.
We have probably maybe about 3 acres of sugar cane. At one time I had a lot more sugar cane because we first planted the sugar cane. When I first came up here, I was given the sugar cane about 30 years ago. This is a Chinese variety. They call it a table cane. And they never grew it commercially because it breaks up. It's really, but you can eat it. It's very soft and very juicy. And it's one of the first things I planted here just because I like to drink sugarcane juice. And it grew, like I couldn't believe how healthy it grew. So this is wintertime, so it's just starting to regrow. But this will get, it's incredible how it grows because I found out later from Hilo to Honolulu, this area grows the finest crops of sugarcane anywhere in the world. Because of the climate, we don't have typhoons, we don't have hurricanes, we have deep soil, we have lots of water, so I thought, okay. And besides that, this is an incredible healing food. There's less sugar per gram in sugarcane than there is in a potato or an apple. Diabetics can drink sugarcane juice. And it's filled with minerals and vitamins that go right to your brain. Now, I planted this field 9 years ago. Conventionally, after 2 to 3 years, they harvest the whole thing with the machine, they plant it again, lots of poisons, but it's a grass, and it just keeps going up. So we harvest it, and we come back, we mulch it, we fertilize it. This field's had IMOs maybe 3 or 4 times. I haven't done it in a couple of years. I'm glad that this is happening. It's going to get everybody on this farm
going again on the IMOs so that we can start putting them back in. But, you know, people, I've been farming on this island for 45 years, and people want to know what to grow. They start talking about all these different crops they want to grow. And I just tell them, look around you. What's growing here? What's always been grown here? Grow the foods. Like I grow cassava. That's one of the oldest food crops to humankind. It's a basic food crop. There's more cassava consumed on this planet, second to rice. It's the basic food of all of Africa and South America. So I grow cassava. I grow kalo, sugarcane, bananas, papayas, things that just really want to grow here, and ulu, and coconuts. And so it's simple, you know. And yeah, we have a nice little vegetable garden, but basically we're growing food. There's enough food here to feed a village all the time. There's plenty of food here. That's what you got to look at doing. So this is, let's go look up here. We can show you some of our papaya trees and how they're pumping out. These coconut trees, this working?
Yeah, sorry.
These coconut trees, I planted about maybe going on 9 years ago. And coconuts, they're like the ulu. They're a miracle tree. It's a medicinal food. The coconut tree is probably the most utilized tree on the planet. In a lot of cultures, you can use every part of this tree for your housing, for your food, for your medicine. So I encourage people to put in some coconut trees. And you see we got the kalo right there. We've got these beautiful lemons. So we're just interspersing everything, you know, together.
Is all your coconuts the short variety or are you all different varieties?
Well, I started this coconut project about 30 years ago. About 10 years ago, I planted 1,400 coconut trees, and it took me about 15 years of searching the entire island. Most of my trees are what they call Malaysians. It's a true dwarf. It's like, you know, these trees will be 45 years old, and I'll still be able to get the coconut standing on the ground. Your Samoans, most people call Samoans dwarfs, but they're actually low-bearing, but they'll get 50 feet tall. And some of these trees are tall because even if you get your seed from a Malaysian, the bees pollinate the flowers and they can cross-pollinate. But, you know, if you get a bunch of seed from a Malaysian, you're probably going to get 90% Malaysians. But there, you know, you got to search. This papaya was developed on Lama Key in 1964. This is not a Thai papaya, it's not a Mexican papaya, it's not a watermelon papaya. This is a Big Island papaya. And it's super sweet. It's really nice.
What the?
It's a Hawaiian variety. Yeah. So, this papaya tree is, I don't know, we planted maybe 7 months ago, 8 months ago, I don't know, I can't remember. This was developed in 1964 down in outside of Pahoa at Malama Key. This isn't a Thai papaya, it's not a Mexican papaya. This is a Big Island papaya. And they're really the kind. So, you know, another important thing about farming that I want to relate to everybody, if you want to be an inspiring farmer, is I was kind of fortunate. I grew up in a dairy farm in the state of Maine, and at 3 o'clock in the morning, I had to be in the barn. And so I've developed this thing about getting up early in the morning and working 7 days a week. And the important thing is that if you really want to do this, you got to do it with a lot of love, a lot of gratitude, because all that feeling that you have in your heart goes into these trees. This is what these trees really feed off of, and this is what these trees give us. Walking around this farm, we feel this gratitude, we feel this love, because these plants are loving it. They're loving us, we're loving them. It's really, farming is a very esoteric thing. It's really way more than what they teach in schools or what you think in your head. Plants are very, very sensitive, like animals. They're very sensitive to feelings and to vibrations. Dogs, cows, horses in particular, they know what you're thinking because they can feel it. And these plants can feel what we're feeling. And that's why, you know, you look at these commercial farmers down here, the guys that grow the papayas and all these plants are so suffering. They're drug addicts. They're just feeding them more drugs and more drugs. And the way they kill their crops, I watch them for decades. When they finish harvesting a crop, they pull back the chemicals and the plant dies. You know, because there's no life in the soil and there's no life on the farm, really. And so these plants, they feel abandoned and they just die. And the other thing, you know, this type of farming that I've been doing on this island, it involves a lot of people. I have an open household. I usually have, right now I have, I don't know, 6, 7, 8, 9 really wonderful young people here that are just, they have their hearts into the land. And that's what it takes. If you really, if you have the opportunity, bring people into it. Find people that want to do this, you know, because you're going to need a lot of help. You know, this is work. This isn't magic. It's work. It's very hard work. You're going to get tired. You're going to get sore. Most important thing when you're farming is to learn how to work ergonomically so that you don't hurt yourself and you can get out there every day and do it. You know, and it's I think the secret in all of this is gratitude. It just keeps coming back to being very thankful that you can get up in the morning and go to work and be in this beautiful garden. You know, that's what keeps me going. So,
hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
That's a secret. There are no secrets.
Okay, on behalf of all of us, I want to thank you, Ginger, John, and Jackie, for your tremendous contribution to this breakthrough movement.
Thank you.
For fully embodying the right steward here.
Wow, thank you. Where's Jackie?
Working somewhere. I know she's working.
How big is this property? How many acres do you have?
10? 8? Are there any questions, anybody?
Do you share your seeds?
Yeah, huh?
Do you share your papaya seeds?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. I share everything, man. It's nothing.
Okay, bye. Yeah. I'll share something.
You just got to get my phone number. You know, this okay. is going to be a few more weeks. We're going to start harvesting this crop. These are awesome papayas, man. They're so sweet.
Good in your face.
They're incredible.
Are these the ones that don't cross-pollinate with the GMO?
Huh?
Are these the ones that don't cross-pollinate with the GMO
ones? Oh, I don't know about that. I don't know about that science, but...
Just curious.
They're good, you know. And if anybody ever wants to grow kalo, I have lots of huli.
Oh.
Yeah, so you just get a hold of me, because, you know, whatever I have here...
I got more than I can deal with, so I love to spread it out so people can. We need to grow kalo.
Yes.
We need to grow ulu.
All right.
And we need to eat it. Give it to our families.
John, do you have bees on property? Do you have any beehives around?
Beehives, yeah, I have beehives on the other side of the farm.
Your own personal?
Yeah.
Yep. How far? Or?
Well, I think you folks have other farms to visit.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I got to get back to work.
Yeah. How many acres do you have?
18.
Thank you, John.
All right.
Yeah, my pleasure.
Got a farm here?
Huh?